Welcome to a lesson on four fundamental differential equations and their solutions. A few equations appear often, and it is useful to just memorize what their solutions are. Let us call them the four fundamental equations. Their solutions are reasonably easy to guess by recalling properties of exponentials, sines, and cosines. They are also simple to check, which is something you should always do. First such equation is dy dx equals ky for some constant k greater than 0. Here, notice y is the dependent and x is the independent variable. The general solution for this equation is y of x equals c times e to the power of kx. And let's go ahead and verify this is the general solution. To do this, we need to verify that dy dx equals k times y. We begin by determining dy dx to differentiate c times e to the power of kx with respect to x. We do have to apply the derivative formula shown here on the right, which includes the chain rule. The derivative of e to the u with respect to x is equal to e to the u times u prime. This indicates that dy dx is equal to c times the derivative of e to the power of kx, which is e to the power of kx times k, which we can write as k times c times e to the power of kx. And now to determine k times y, well, k times y is just k times c times e to the power of kx, and we're done. We've shown dy dx is equal to k times y. Next, we have dy dx equals negative ky, for some constant k greater than 0. The general solution for this equation is y of x equals c times e raised to the power of negative kx. And again, let's go ahead and verify this. For the first step, we'll determine dy dx. Applying the chain rule, dy dx is equal to c times the derivative of e to the power of negative kx, which is e to the power of negative kx times negative k, which we can write as negative k times c times e to the power of negative kx. And now to determine the right side, which is negative k times y. Well, negative k times y is negative k times c times e to the power of negative kx. We have now shown that dy dx is equal to negative ky. This verifies the general solution is y of x. Next, take the second order differential equation. The second derivative of y with respect to x equals negative k squared y for some constant k greater than 0. The general solution for this equation is y of x equals c sub 1 cosine kx plus c sub 2 sine kx. And again, let's go ahead and verify the solution by determining the second derivative of y with respect to x, and then we'll determine negative k squared times y. We begin by determining the first derivative. The first derivative is equal to the derivative of c sub 1 cosine kx plus the derivative of c sub 2 sine kx. And the derivative of c sub 1 cosine kx is equal to c sub 1 times negative sine kx times k, applying the chain rule, which we can write as negative k c sub 1 sine kx. And the derivative of c sub 2 sine kx is equal to c sub 2 cosine kx times k, which we can write as plus k c sub 2 cosine kx. And now we need to determine the second derivative, which is a derivative of the first derivative. Differentiating the first derivative, the derivative of negative k c sub 1 sine kx is equal to negative k c sub 1 cosine kx times k, which we can write as negative k squared c sub 1 cosine kx. And the derivative of k c sub 2 cosine kx is equal to k c sub 2 negative sine kx times k, which gives us minus k squared c sub 2 sine kx. Next, we determine negative k squared y. Negative k squared y is equal to negative k squared times y of x, distributing negative k squared. We have negative k squared c sub 1 cosine kx minus k squared sine kx. And notice y double prime is equal to negative k squared y. And therefore, we've shown the second derivative of y with respect to x is equal to negative k squared y. And finally, for our last equation, we have the second order differential equation. The second derivative of y with respect to x is equal to k squared y for some constant k greater than 0. Here the general solution can take two forms. The general solution can be y of x equals c sub 1 e to the power of kx plus c sub 2 e to the power of negative kx, or y of x equals d sub 1 hyperbolic cosine kx plus d sub 2 hyperbolic sine kx. Now below we have the exponential definitions of hyperbolic cosine x and hyperbolic sine x. Again, these are called hyperbolic cosine and hyperbolic sine. These functions are sometimes easier to work with than exponentials. They have some nice familiar properties, such as hyperbolic cosine 0 equals 1 and hyperbolic sine 0 equals 0, as well as the derivative of hyperbolic cosine x equals hyperbolic sine x, and the derivative of hyperbolic sine x is equal to hyperbolic cosine x. Let's go ahead and verify the solution y of x equals d sub 1 hyperbolic cosine kx plus d sub 2 hyperbolic sine kx. To find the first and second derivatives, we do have to apply the chain rule, meaning we have to use the derivative formulas shown here in the blue box on the right. Applying the chain rule, the derivative of d sub 1 hyperbolic cosine kx is equal to k times d sub 1 times hyperbolic sine kx plus the derivative of d sub 2 hyperbolic sine kx with respect to x is equal to k times d sub 2 times hyperbolic cosine kx. And then to find the second derivative, we differentiate the first derivative. I'll let you go ahead and check this. The second derivative is equal to k squared d sub 1 hyperbolic cosine kx plus k squared d sub 2 hyperbolic sine kx. The next step is to determine k squared times y, where y is the general solution y of x. Distributing k squared, notice the second derivative of y with respect to x is equal to k squared y, verifying y of x is a general solution to the given differential equation. I hope you found this helpful.